Hello everyone. In today's video, we'll cover a wide range of topics and it will be a bit longer than my previous videos. For your benefit, I have added timelines in the description, so please make sure to check it if you want to save your time. With an example today, we'll understand the following: how to read and upload files into AWS S3, file comparison and report generation using Python, and Slack integration using Python Slack SDK. In order to understand the use case, there are a couple of prerequisites which you need to understand, like what is an S3 bucket, objects, what is Slack app, the OAuth tokens, and Slack channel. If you are already aware about these, you may skip directly to the example. From the AWS official documentation, S3 stands for Simple Storage Service. It stores your files as objects in AWS, and all these files are stored in buckets. A bucket is a container of these objects. There are some benefits of S3. It allows you versioning in order to prevent any accidental overwrite of your file, and also has control list permissions, which you may combine with IAM policies in order to restrict your buckets for read and write permissions at a granular level. To create a bucket in S3, go to S3, click on Create Bucket. Enter your bucket name. The name should be globally unique, meaning bucket name should be unique throughout the AWS. You cannot add spaces and uppercase letters as well. Fill in the other details, tags, etc., bucket versioning, whether you want to enable it or disable it, any additional settings which you would like to have in your bucket, and click on Create Bucket. For our example today, I have already created a bucket here. You can create a folder within your bucket or also upload your local files and folder in the bucket. Next is Slack. Slack is a messaging app used for collaborative purposes. It functions similar to Microsoft Teams. We have channels in Slack, which is a space organized for people to talk about a particular subject. For example, I have a YT channel for YouTube. You may have separate channel for separate subjects. Next are Slack apps. Slack apps are bots that help you interact with different services like Calendar, Zoom, Drive, all integrated in a single workspace. We can build our own apps as well. Go to App Directory, click on Build, create an app. Give your app a name, let's say dummy app for YT. Select your workspace and click on create app. Now, in order to interact with this app, we need to add some scope or capabilities to your app. For our example, we'll be requiring three particular scopes. There are a list of scopes available here and you can check in the documentation. So we would require chat write and files read and write. Once we add these scopes, we get an option to install this app to our workspace. On clicking this, an OAuth token will be generated, which we will be using for our app authentication in our code. Yeah, just click on allow and after this, your OAuth token will be generated. Once your OAuth token is generated, you can see the app listed under the app section. Next, we'll integrate our app to our channel. Go to YT, go to integrations, click on add apps and select the app. You can see that the app has been added to this channel. To understand this flow, we have taken a use case of an IT admin who wants to monitor the assets that have been changed for a particular employee and also generate a report and share it to the team of the changed assets. I already have a bucket created in S3 and this is the sample file which I'll be using, assetdetails.txt. Coming to the code has been published to GitHub and the GitHub repo link, I'll add it in the description. This is our main file. All these sensitive and unique values are passed as command line arguments. This new file contains the new asset details of the employee, like the laptop number, mouse, headphones, monitor. This is the name of the report which we want to generate. And this is our primary function which we are calling here. We first read the file from S3, the asset TXT file which we just saw, and store it under the resources section. Next, we compare the file retrieved from S3 and the local file. This we do using the difflib in Python. And then we generate an HTML report of this difference and store it in the PNG format. Next, we send this output PNG file to our Slack channel. For this, you require the app OAuth token and the channel ID. The channel ID you can retrieve from the About section of the channel. This is your channel ID. And after that, we upload the new file to S3 as well as the report PNG file to S3 in the same bucket. If you're using the IDE, the command line arguments can be passed from here. I've added my values as command line arguments. Let's run the script. So first we'll read from S3. We'll verify that the asset details file is added in this resources section. The file has been added. Next, we'll have a comparison report generated. We can verify that the report has been generated. Let's open this. Yeah, original change, and these are the assets that have been changed for this particular employee. Next, we'll send this report to our Slack channel. Okay, this message has been sent by our dummy app, and this is the file which we saw in the previous step as well. After that, we upload this file to S3. We'll verify whether the file has been added to our bucket. Yes, the new file has been added. And last, we'll upload the report file as well. That's it, the function has ended. And all three files are present in our S3 bucket. So that is all I had for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Happy learning.